couldn't come at a worse time. Of course, we're coming up on the Christmas weekend celebrated across the world, but this is known locally as Typhoon Nina. So these names are interchangeable. So it's Nakhten internationally, Typhoon Nina locally. It's 850 kilometers east of Manila, capital city right now, and this storm is really starting to pack a punch, looking very, very organized at the moment. We do anticipate a landfalling typhoon or super typhoon in southern Luzon, specifically the Bicol region, late Sunday evening into early Monday morning. And of course, we've got Manila also in this path. And that means that one of the largest population densities across the Philippines will feel the brunt of this storm. So giving you as much of a heads up as possible if you are watching out of the Philippines right now, because this storm looks dangerous. 205 kilometer per hour sustained winds near the center of circulation, and it is still rapidly intensifying. Look at the notable storms that have made landfall across the past 5 years in the month of December. Remember, it only needs to be a tropical storm to produce a significant amount of rainfall and also, unfortunately, cause a significant amount of fatalities. I remember Hagupit back in December of 2014. That was a significant storm with very strong winds. Here's the path. Cone of uncertainty. You can see Legazpi in there. Manila also in the that cone. It is intensifying as we speak. We do expect this to reach super typhoon status, which is minimum sustained winds of 230 kilometers per hour. You can see how quickly it is jumped up in that category. The threats going forward, landslides, urban flooding. We have the potential for 3 to 4 meters of storm surge, especially across those east-facing shorelines across the Philippines. And wow, I mean, we're talking about the holiday season here. So many people going to friends and family's house, but having to deal with a storm of this magnitude will be very, very challenging in the days to come.